you know, a lot of people are really not even aware that they can come out to their local track and legally drag race. They think it's something as like a professional sport only. So, I'm going to kind of give you a walkthrough here. We're going to actually going to pay an entry fee. We're going to get tacked in. Wave at the security dude.
How's it going? Good. How are you?
Good. Are you racing?
Yes, I am.
Am I on TV?
Yes, you are.
All right. What you got here is a tech sheet. He's going to look over the car, make sure all is well, and that I'm not some tool who hooked up a nitrous kit in my carport going to blow up out there on the track. Not that that's not entertaining when that happens. Not everything you see on Tesla tonight will be a race car.
After you go through tech with your fully completed tech card, and it gets signed by one of our nice tech guys like Mr. Joe right over there, then you just want to take it up to room 112 where you'll sign the waiver and get your arm back.
Thank you, Mr. Duke. And you know, that segues right into a very good point. Always make buddies with the drag racing manager. It allows you to get away with shenanigans so you don't get kicked right on out of here. I'm shooting a drag racing 101 video.
You are?
And it now stars you.
Well, good, Grinner. Do you have your permanent car number?
Sweet. She's always a ray of sunshine, and she gave me this. And the last two digits are my car number. I'm going to hand this to the tech dude. He's going to put my number on my car. Man, that's pretty much it.
Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. What lane should I get in?
Just get in 1-2.
Slot lane one here is my buddy. Now I'm just randomly gonna line up against this Turbo Supra. And you can come out here with your buddies. You can trade places. You can race each other. It's a good time your first go around to run through the paces before you start doing that. You're gonna buckle up here. They will yell at you. And in this case, I'll put the camera down about, you know what I'm saying? I haven't exactly been told not to do this, but, you know. All right, you see a little sign here, water, no water. Basically, street radials are slicks, and I'm sporting my street radials. I'm gonna pull up here in the no water line. I don't really need to smoke them. I tell you, it looks pretty cool, but I'd be doing myself no benefit at all. What I am going to do is do a baby burnout and get the stuff off my tires. Check this out. See there? I just scuffed them up a little bit. What you're going to do is hit this pre-stage beam and turn it on. When you do, you hop the brake until that second one comes on. When it does, it is on like Donkey Kong. Narrating and drag racing at the same time takes a little practice, a whole lot of coordination. It does add to the rush. Let's see what I ran. Do a little circle at the end of the track. You head on back to the ticket guy. Now your adrenaline's pumping here. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't guilty of hanging an occasional fishtail around that very corner back there. Don't be doing that, man. It'll get you yelled at.
So what's up, brother?
Thank you, brother.
See you, man.
Happy guy. What do you think I ran? You're supposed to, like, really, just drive, not read your ticket here. Now, your time slip will show your reaction time. That's my .239 right there. There's a 60-foot and a 330-foot, an eighth mile, my miles per hour in that eighth mile, 1,000-foot. The quarter mile time, that's that 14.130, that's what I ran in that quarter, at 95.45 miles an hour. Well, not very impressive. Keep in mind, I did that while talking to you, so that ain't that bad. Perhaps the most important tip I can give you, first time drag racers, before you leave, park your car, buy some nachos, watch a few runs. Don't hang a right, get on the highway, do 144 like an idiot. I'm Grinner Hester, and you're watching Mod Night.
Come on, car.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.